Hi guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I will be answering my most frequently asked question ever: how I became a photographer. But before we get into the video, I just want to say a huge thank you for you guys helping me reach 1,000 subscribers. I didn't even think that this was possible in this time frame. And also for helping my Pep Home video reach 15,000 views. I'm literally still in shock. Like, I couldn't even fathom the number as I still see it growing. But thank you so much. And to my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. And I really hope that you enjoy your time here on my channel. What I'd like to add into this video before we start is that I am a self-taught photographer. I learned most of my skills on YouTube by asking other people, other photographers, and just growing myself from there and learning from my mistakes. So in this video, you will learn how to go from nothing to something, and from literally teaching yourself everything you know with a laptop, with a camera, and how you can grow it into a business. But without any further ado, let's get into the video. So my journey of becoming a photographer was very unconventional. It wasn't me going to study or anything down those lines. So I'm gonna start from the beginning. This whole photography journey started at about 13 or 14 years old. My friends actually used to come over for sleepovers, and I would dress them up, I would do their makeup, and I had like this blank wall in my room, and I would just make them stand there, take all types of pictures of them with my small little digital camera, you know, those ones that, like, when you press the button to go on, this, like, the lens comes out. And yeah, so I had a camera like that, and I just used to take pictures of all my friends. I'm sure they can recall me dressing them up and taking pictures of them. At the end of that year, when I was in grade 8, that Christmas, I received my first camera. Let me get it. So this is the first camera that I ever got. This was the most professional one that I got, and I was really so excited for this. Then from that day, I just became the designated photographer in our family. I take pictures at every family function, and yeah, I just enjoyed it. Like, I didn't think that it would go further than there at that point. I just really enjoyed taking photos, and I always had my camera with me. In school holidays, I'd go to family, and if I knew my cousins would be there, I would just take pictures of them. So yeah, that's basically how it started. That is like the main foundation of the story. And then from there, my first big function, or my first wedding, was actually my cousin Janine's wedding. And I was hired to do groom prep, but I just remember taking the pictures of all the groom and my cousins getting done at their house, and then just a few pictures of the wedding as it went on through the day. And then one holiday, I think it was the following year, I went to Joburg to visit some family, and then one night I just randomly was talking to my uncle about my photography, and he was like, why don't you create a Facebook page? And at that time, I didn't even know you could have a Facebook page for your business or anything like that. I thought Facebook was just a place for fun and to post things like, here's my mix-it pin, whatever. It was that age, literally. And then he just helped me put together a Facebook page, and I uploaded my first album of some of the previous work that I already did. And I just wanted a place to showcase my work so that people could see it, besides just being on my personal Facebook. And then from there, the page grew, and I just kept uploading my work. And then I started getting messages on the Facebook page asking, do you do functions? Can you come take pictures at this, at that? And I was like, you want me to take pictures at your events? And it was strange, as it was people that I didn't even know. And then I said yes, and I was like, okay, this is a good opportunity, I can learn. But I was still super nervous, and I didn't charge anyone. When I started out, this was during my high school days, I never really charged anyone, but some shoots used to be far, so I'd need to drive really far, and obviously I couldn't drive myself. I needed to ask my parents or my grandparents, and they obviously spent hours driving me around, and shoot, I'm still so grateful for that. So they said, no, we need petrol money. And I was like, okay, fine, I'll at least charge my clients petrol money. And I started charging them petrol money, and my parents never took the money. They just wanted me to get paid for the work that I was doing, which I look back on now, and I was like, that petrol money was a step that I needed to go further. Anyway, right through high school, I did shoots here and there, not taking it really seriously, but in my matric year, that's when I started taking it a bit more seriously. So in my matric year, on weekends, that's when I really started picking up and started to get busy. My first price that I charged people was 150 rand for a shoot. I am not kidding at all. I actually went this morning to go check some old messages of clients where I charged that price, and I was like, back then I was embarrassed to charge 150 rand because I was like, oh no, they're not gonna want to pay, like I'm not a photographer, like I can't take these people's money, and not thinking about the effort that I have to go through to get there, to drive, and my hours that I spent there that I could have been studying. Or I just felt so guilty about charging that price, and now that I look back, I'm like, that price is embarrassing that I actually charged that, to tell you that now. I guess that's where we all need to start out somewhere. And so I charged 150 rand and my parents would need to sit in the car for hours. I have pictures of my dad taking pictures of me actually working while he sat and waited for me. 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Also keep in mind, when you are this cheap, people can afford to book you for long periods of time. So I was booked for 3 hours at the shoot at the time because I was so cheap, people could afford it. I would help set up, I would take pictures, and I would help set down the entire party, because that's how early I was and that's how late they could afford to make me leave. So I know of plenty of examples where I helped set up the party and even took down the party, and then I left. And those were people I don't know. Like, I just felt really guilty standing in the corner and watching them run late and me doing nothing about it. So yeah, I always say, can I help? Where can I help? And that's basically what happens when you are so cheap. So when I started getting really serious about photography, it was my gap year, and that was in 2017. Keep in mind, it was 2016 when I was in matric and charging 150 rand. In 2017, I was like, whoa, I'm getting too busy. I'm rewriting a subject. This is my gap year. I'm going to try and make photography work, but also get my studies in order. And I was like, I can't be charging 150 rand. I need to up my prices. And I upped it, not by much, but to me at that time, it was a lot of money. I knew with increasing our prices would come with some slowing in business, because obviously if people's used to paying a certain price for you and you jump your price the next year, it might just make them take a step back and be like, no, it's fine, I'll just get someone who is still 150 rand. And I just mentally prepared myself that with this price increase, I'll lose some bookings, which I was okay with, because I just said, it's fine, I'll take it in my stride, and I'll use it to do my studies. If it's meant to be, it will be. And then 2017 actually turned out being my most busy year ever. From going from charging 150 rand to charging 450 rand, I became even more busy, which was insane. Maybe because there was a bigger market prepared to pay 450, thinking that they're going to get better quality, which my quality did improve. And maybe if you're too cheap, people might be like, nah, I don't know what she's going to do if she's that cheap. Like, so cheer from there, I continued to increase my prices. And each year, increasing the prices just made me get even more and more busy, which is insane. Like, I still can't believe it. I even have clients coming from my cheap days who still come back to me and still take the prices that I have now, and they never question it. They just accept that it is what it is. And I think that if you can show your clients that you are improving every year and that you can justify your price increase, people aren't scared to pay. Also, since I've been able to increase my rates, I've been able to invest in better equipment and just run my business more smoothly, because when I was cheaper, I constantly felt like I was making a loss, because I still gave them this whole package in the deal with 150 rand. I gave them this entire package, and most of my money went to prints, DVDs, chocolates, whatever I included in the package. And then when I looked back at the end of the day, there was like a 20 rand left for me. And so what I've learned from starting out as a cheap photographer is that I really enjoy what I do. I still have that same butterfly feeling that I felt in the beginning that I feel now before each and every shoot. I never get used to it. I always sometimes have to take myself back and be like, they actually want to book me out of all the people, me? So yeah, I still get those moments a lot. I still feel starstruck a lot of the time. But I think it's just coming to terms with how much I've grown. You sometimes don't see your own growth. until someone points it out to you and be like, did you see, this is how your photos used to look, did you see how it looks now, or something along those lines. And then it makes you look back and you be like, wow, I've actually really come so far. And what this journey has also taught me was to be humble, to be grateful for everything I have now that I might not have had all those years ago, that I still made it work. Another thing that we like to do as people is to wait till we have a certain thing. Wait till we have this camera. Wait till we have this lighting to start a YouTube channel. It's never about that. Start with what you have. I'm filming on my phone, Samsung Galaxy S7. And people sometimes even ask me what my settings are on my camera for filming my YouTube videos. So it's not about where you start, it's about how you finish. And start with what you have. If you have a phone and you want to do photography, learn how to use that phone to the best of your ability. I only upgraded my camera, the small one that I started out with, once I used it till I couldn't anymore, till I outgrew that camera, till the pictures that I wanted it couldn't give me anymore, and that's why I upgraded. I didn't just run to get the next best thing. I tried my best and did the best with what I had till I feel like I outgrew that. And that is kind of something that I want you guys to know, because I know a lot of people, I want to do photography but I don't have this, I bought this camera but I don't know how to use it. There's so much resources out there, there's YouTube videos, there's other photographers who aren't scared to help if you just ask. So yeah, don't make excuses. And I think that's what I just kept persevering. There was times when I got my new camera and I didn't know how to use it at all. I was like, why did I waste my money on this camera? I should have just bought another one. Like, I struggled to use that settings. I did two shoots and the light and the white balance was totally off. The pictures were like red and pink and I was just regretting everything about the camera. And now I love it so much. So you're gonna make mistakes. You're going to fail sometimes, but it's about how you get up at the end of the day. And if you keep pushing, and don't give up. If it's something you really want to do, people are going to tell you, don't do this, become a teacher, become a lawyer, become that, you know, everything that's like ideal in the world of rainbows. And when in your heart you actually want to become a singer, a dancer, a poet, an artist, do it on the side. Get your studies out of the way. Do what your parents say, yes, because it is good to have something to fall back on, but don't give up on your dream. Keep doing it, keep at it, and if it's meant to be, it will always be. But one last thing I want to add before we end off this video is that it's not about becoming a photographer, it's about the journey. I'm still learning, I'm still getting better every day. I never woke up one day and I was like, today, because of this, I'm a photographer. I am still very much learning. I still consider myself to be a rookie in the game, but whatever knowledge I have that I can share with you, I'll gladly do it, because when I started all this, there wasn't as many people around that I could even ask for help. So being self-taught, yes, it is hard, but it's also so worth it once you get to where you need to be. It's so much more rewarding. So there you have it, guys. That is my photography journey in a nutshell. I hope I answered all the questions and everything that you guys may have wanted to know with regards to my photography journey. If you do have any questions, you can pop it in the comments down below and I'll do my best to reply to every single comment and maybe even do a part 2 if there's enough questions. But if you did enjoy this video, guys, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe down below and turn on the bell so that you can be notified whenever I upload. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye.